Alright, people, we'll be getting it started. The person who is going to be joining me, Lunar, is not here at the current moment, but hopefully he'll be coming soon. Just going to go ahead and get it started. So, what you see on the screen here is the Phantom Yubel. So, I went back and worked on it some more. And I kind of got it the way I liked it. You know, first I kind of start with the deck, how it's suggested, and then I start jimmying with it and make it into my own creation. So, this is the outcome, so plan on doing a couple of duels with this deck and hopefully do well with it. So, of course, one of each Yubel, then, despite what Omega said, the fours, they just didn't seem that good in comparison to threes. The threes are the ones to go with, so we're going to go with three. So, three of the Ancient Cloak, three of the Silent Boots, and three of the Rugged Glove, so we can pull this off, this guy off, who will not only be able to pop himself and do the stuff, but he can also pop just a card on each side of the field, including, you know, Tear to turn into Ultimate Nightmare. So, hopefully we'll be able to do that play and go a little bit on the offensive instead of just sitting defensively with Tear. It's kind of like having a Diamond Dire Wolf, except, you know, through this engine. Alright, so it's kind of like a little pseudo Scrime Dragon, not bad. Then, of course, all my senders, all these guys are dark, so not only will we be sending Yubel, but we'll be sending all the rest of these guys. They each have, like, a graveyard effect. You can banish this card to add one Phantom Knight card from your deck to your hand. Banish this card to add one Phantom, or Phantom Knight Speller Trap, and then I think this guy, you can banish him to send one Phantom Knight or Phantom Speller Trap card from your deck to your graveyard. So, all of them are pretty good when it comes to graveyard effects. Repetition, just for more sending. One red, of course, Foolish Burial, because there is a lot of banishing. These guys banish themselves to get their effects, so Burial. Then this thing's like a Trap Stun, so Special Summon the monster, this level 3, so of course you can exceed with that monster. Then during your turn, except the turn that's sent to the graveyard, you can banish this card from your graveyard and target one face-up trap your opponent controls, and it gets effect to the end of the turn. So, you know, there's something, the trap that's about to mess me up, you can just be like, nah, let me go and banish this and stun it. Then, of course, Limit Reverse, Phantom Sword, gain that 800 attack and protect me from being destroyed by battle by card effect. Well, if I would be destroyed by battle by card effect, this card would be destroyed instead. And when that monster leaves, destroy this monster, you can banish this card from your graveyard, then target one Phantom Knight monster in your graveyard, and special summon it, but banish it when it leaves the field, but as long as I exceed with the monster, then when I detach it, it'll just go back to the graveyard. Fog Blade's kind of like a weird Phoenix Chain, activate this by targeting one effect monster, effects are negated, cannot attack, and other monsters cannot target for an attack, so pretty much just like, hey, stop from attacking, then I have Yubel, and Yubel will go ahead and kill you, so, yeah. And you can banish this card to target one Phantom Knight monster, your graveyard special summon it. Then Oasis and Call of the Hunted for more revival. And we got some rank 4, some rank 3s, Dark Rebellion. He's probably going to be the main go-to guy, that's why there's 3. He just becomes a super beater. Just summon him, pop himself, pop that. Then he'll summon the monsters back as level 4s, but I had to go into a dark, so 9 times a 10 will probably be Dark Rebellion. We also have Donatellus just in case. And we have Mind Stroke for more defensive play, some rank 3s, because there's some 3s, Castell, and Diamond Direwolf. So, yeah, we're just going to be trying this deck out, waiting for Lunar to join. And then as soon as he joins, we can actually get the string started. But for now, I'm just going to go ahead and do a couple of duels with this deck. I think I'm fairly used to it. Hopefully, I don't mess up too bad. So, with the high amount of revival and stuff like that, hopefully I can just stay in the game through and out-resource my opponent, which is generally what you see this deck do a lot. You know, it's a very resource-heavy deck. I think I'll go ahead and go first, you know. I see that often where you have a ton of resources in comparison to your opponent, and you keep reviving your cards and doing your plays. So this hand's not terrible. I can go ahead and summon Armageddon Knight. Armageddon Knight can go ahead and send me one of my Phantom Knights, and my opponent has no extra deck, so it's looking suspicious. Summon Armageddon Knight. Armageddon Knight, I still need to figure out the ratio. On paper, it looks fine, but I still need to figure out. So I can go ahead and send, not Silent Boots, but I can send Cloak, and then Cloak can banish me to get me Boots, which is actually pretty good. Then I would have Boots, and I do have my Shield. Oh, there you are.
Yeah, sorry, I was eating dinner.
Okay. So I would have my Boots, and I would have my Shield, and then there's the rank 3 right there, so... That's not terrible. So I think I'll go ahead and do it. I can send you Bell, but since my opponent doesn't have an extra deck, I'm feeling like this duel might get a little bit sacky. So I'll go ahead and send him to the graveyard. Then use his effect. And go ahead and banish. go ahead and get my search, and I'll just go ahead and get me boots.
I'm not gonna lie, I don't know what the new traps do for Phantom Knights.
One's like kind of like a mini trap stun. It summons a level three monster that I can see with, and then during my turn, except this turn of Ascent to the Graveyard, I can banish it, then target a face up trap and negate it. So,
oh, nice.
Stop one trap, and then sword, of course. You should know sword.
Yeah.
Like I said, I don't trust this duel. This guy has no extra, so either he's doing something sacky, or he's a scrub, or a noob. So, I'm not sure. Of course, drawing terror is always fun. Alright, set a monster. That's fine. I can go ahead and pop that monster if I choose to. And said that rank 3, like definitely play 3 of him. He's so good. He's like a little scrap dragon. And you know how much I love scrap dragon and Yubel decks. Is that all you're going to do? Just set one monster? At least set some back row. It's been seriously thinking. Come on. Set a monster, now what? What's up, Mal? I said that a lot of their trap cards have revival for themselves, so it doesn't seem like I need so much revival like Call and Oasis like that, but it's mostly for Yubel and like Armageddon and Dark Ref for more rank 4 plays.
Yeah.
I shouldn't have to use the revival cards on these guys. Their own trap cards.
Yeah, all of their traps are revivals.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm going to try to do. Out-resource my opponent and apply a lot of pressure. That's it? Okay. Set one monster. I'll do another boots. So, control that Phantom. Once you spend this card in your hand, you can only spend one boots once per turn. This way, match this card and then add one Phantom Knight spell or trap card from your deck to your hand. Okay. Guess I should go. I'm just going to go ahead and summon boots. Activate the shield, put in the monster zone, and exceed these two. Then that will be in the graveyard to stop any trap that he decides to do against me. I guess I'll just go to my go-to guy. I don't think I want you to kill yourself, but I'm not sure what I want you to do.
What rank 4 darks do you run? Oh, three.
Dark Rebellion, Thanatos, and My Stroke.
Yeah, it's pretty.
And cool. I guess I could probably put a Karagorgon, but
I like Karagorgon.
My question is, do I want to pop? I'm thinking about maybe just popping Armageddon and popping a set. When this card is sent,
I'm
destroyed. Period. Okay, I was wondering if it was like destroyed battle or destroyed card. Just destroyed. Period. So I'll go ahead and use my effect. Detach and Armageddon Knight to destroy your card. He probably doesn't know what I'm talking about, so I'll probably just go ahead and copy and paste. I could probably drop it down to 2, but for right now on testing, I don't want to run into a situation where I'm just like, wow, I wish I had a third Dark Rebellion, especially with how quickly you pump out these knights and go into that Dark Rebellion. Just like, pop a card, Dark Rebellion. Dark Rebellion cuts you in half, gain that strength. Like, Dark Rebellion is so good. It's like pretty much like a staple XC at this point. My opponent's like straight up not doing anything. I might just go back
in with him and Castell. Okay then.
Oh, okay. What do I think of the calculator in Yubel decks? It's okay. I mean, the problem is that you're relying too much on the strength of the calculator, and if you don't have the combination with Yubel, it's not that strong. And you have to have it with Ultimate Nightmare to get the full strength, because if you have it with Yubel, then you're tripping off the first one, you're tripping off monsters, Terror's just going to wipe them, so... Okay, I guess. Okay.
I'd never seen that normal monster before.
I read that as pervert rat. What? I said that wasn't a very arousing duel anyway. It really wasn't doing much. Someone's a little higher rating. You're after me.
You tried Yubel XZ since the spiders.
No, not really. I guess I could.
It could be alright.
So you want to do that? I guess I'll go second. I still need to figure out whether this deck has to go first or second. There's some plays that it likes to go first and play, some plays that it has to go second. Yo, this hand's kind of meh. It's more of a first turn hand. Unless I get like a, unless I get boots. I need Puss in Boots. Fogblaze and Gate. I have the Tomb Shield. So. And then of course I draw a form of Yubel. I should just run like three of each Yubel so I never draw Yubel. So that's how I felt about Calculator. It was an OG card. It helps you learn more aggressively, but you just gotta make sure it's being played correctly. That's my problem with him. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and summon Mathematician. You, so I guess it's a fine exchange. I draw my Ultimate Nightmare one, but then I draw that Mathematician at one. So I'm gonna go ahead and send Cloak. I'll use Cloak's effect. Finish Cloak, give me boots, and then I have my plays for next turn.
What do you think of that new hand trap? The, not Yuki Usagi, but...
The one that
same, finished like, this one. The real. Same kind of art. The one that...
I'll probably do a card review about it.
Hit something out your opponent's extra deck with.
Yeah, I'll probably do a card review about it.
Seems very niche.
Shall we three cards in the deck in combination of DDs from your hand for a graveyard, and you can add two DD monsters from your deck to your hand. So you're going to put those three back to get two. So yeah. You use four to get two.
Yeah. You meant to put them back from your grave?
Yeah. That was super neg. Super Neg. I hope it was worth it.
DDs don't normally play that card either.
I mean, clearly from Daily Duels, I am a terrible DDD player that has no idea what he's doing. But at least I know not to play that like that. Like, if it, yeah, from the graveyard, sure. But
I played a lot of DD in my time.
You play with a lot of Ds in your time?
Oh, all the time. 3 Ds going on.
Yeah. Just one in each hand and one in the mouth. All the bees. So I hope it was worth it. Hopefully you entertain me with your DD plays. So obviously you're going to get slime. And then what else? I guess Kepler, maybe?
Well, watch him get two scales. Set them. And then just do nothing.
Actually, that's the two I would get. Kepler and slime.
Yeah.
Hurry up. Damn.
Oh, okay. Next,
normally I'd use Yubel in Low Eater, tribute Low Eater for Yubel, go down in power, but wouldn't get tributed. Wow, oh, he quit. I wasn't even paying attention.
Mm-hmm. He was out of there.
I gotta look at something, because I believe that Level Eater actually doesn't work.
He can't be tributed.
Except yeah, tribute. See, this face of a card on the field cannot be tributed except for tribute summon, so you can't tribute Level Eater to keep Yubel on the field.
Really screwed me over the other day. I forgot that I was playing like a red Archfiend deck, and I was like, "Oh, I'll eat off of the level 10 and then sacrifice the level eater to summon back the level 9." And it's like, "Oh, I can't.
I can't do that." So he did that play, went super neg, and then just quit because I guess he couldn't think of 2 DMVs. Like, wow.
He definitely screwed up. He built the deck wrong to begin with. I don't like that. One, the scale he revealed, the one that you discard to get one out your grave. I can see the use of it, but...
I mean, now since I'm better with the deck, it just seems like Lilith does a better job and allows you for more plays.
I wouldn't run more than one if I was running it.
So Lilith be putting that work in Lamia, too. Take your time. I am not in a hurry. We've got a cool minute.
He's TJ Hinking.
All right.
What's there to think about?
Yeah, I mean, what's there to think about? Skill is trash. There's no thinking. Summon Riders, mill as much as possible. Go to Minerva, mill as much as possible. Draw cards, mill enemy drawn cards, and just go as stupid as possible. Like, it's... What's there to think about? It's still skill is trash, no matter how angle... What angle you take it at, whether it be just dropping JD or dropping Minervas with performances. Skill is trash, the skill is trash. Sorry, the disrespect is real, but I seriously do not like Light Thorns. I've never liked Light Thorns.
Whoa, two tuners.
No. Both of them are tuners.
I was gonna say, when he's pitching them both, I was like, what is he doing? Or maybe he's tributing him for something. No, back to extra. Okay, he knows.
Yeah. Put that expensive synchro back.
Yeah. Have you seen that deck that was doing pretty well, the synchro deck, where that gets out three omegas and a Trish on the first turn and your opponent has no hand?
God damn.
Yeah, and it does it really consistently.
God damn, that sounds evil as hell.
And it won that tournament, but I can't remember.
Foolish wolf. Yep. Are we going to see some Minerva action? Or are you just
made gonna... this deck, trying to get used to
it. Oh, now you're going to go ahead and go into... Yeah, that works. Yeah, Omega. That is fine.
Hey.
Omega's so annoying to deal with.
Mm-hmm.
I'm hopping out of the way and shit.
Speaking of hopping out of the way, I've been playing some Chain Beat. It's still really powerful, even though it's ancient.
When does it come back? During the next standby phase?
Yeah. Right?
I believe so.
Or is it during his next?
I think it's during the next standby phase. It's during your opponent's standby phase. No. Oh, okay. No, that's not it.
No, that's the other one.
Blah, 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 blah. Until your next standby phase.
Okay.
Yeah, you can banish this card from your opponent's hand. To your next time. Okay, so that's annoying. And he took like the fucking perfect card from me too. He took my fucking boots. You jerk.
You can search another one with Rota.
Yeah. Oh, they're warriors, aren't they? Yeah, they are. Mm-hmm. Keep on forgetting that. I think they keep on thinking they're fiends. Because they look so fiendish. Alright, give me my boots. I said, I have no idea how I'm going to dealt that Omega for right now. Yeah, you don't face palm, you face you. Alright, so I'll go ahead and normal summon you. Special summon you. You two. I'll probably just go ahead and just run him over. There's really no reason to do my effect and stuff like that.
Hmm.
If he has honest, then fuck it. I mean, I still summon my two monsters back, so.
Yeah.
Honest is till the end of the turn or end of the battle phase, off the top of my mind. I want to say the end of the turn, isn't it?
Wait, did he take 300? He should have only took one because he gets the buff from Raiden.
Did he mill Light Thorn?
Yeah, he milled two.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, he milled one. He milled the Phidias.
Raiden was. Right.
Okay, he realized.
No, that's all I got. Go ahead. So, during your standby phase, I'll go ahead and get this back to my hand, and you get your Omega back, and Omega just bees and is just annoying, top it out the way and stuff. It would be pretty good if I just didn't have other synchro monsters that just deal with that handle Yubel better, like Beals. When he get damaged, Doug, I guess he milled it during the end phase.
Yeah.
Well, I don't like racing this deck. Just because it's not a real deck. Like, that's my problem with this deck. It's not a fucking real deck. You play all the Minervas and shit, and there's no way in fuck anybody has enough Minervas. I mean, you even go to Minerva, so I guess you're showing that you don't need to, but still.
Hmm.
I'm watching you, motherfucker. End of battle phase? Alright, thank you. Because I was to say, if it was till the end of the turn, that would have been a great play. Just attack you on, it's me, I die, come back with two level 4s, then go to main phase 2, make a Dark Rebellion, and steal half of your shit. Oh, shit. Alright.
Fair charge.
Yep, fair charge. Said this deck was easily accessible. I wonder what tier it would be. It's a good question.
Hmm.
You only get one right in effect, so. No.
Once per turn.
Once per turn.
Oops. He missed the ones for turn.
I didn't copy the ones for turn. Probably just go ahead and make like a Scrap Dragon or a Castell.
Or Minerva.
Yep, there's Minerva. Mm-hmm. How much is she? Thousands of dollars? $2,000?
Looks like they didn't even sell it on TCG Player.
Mm.
Yeah, well, you know, it might get printed in 2 years' time.
What am I doing? I'm doing an impossible duel.
How long did it take Giant Hand?
Years. I'm already not amused by this duel.
The worst thing is when they've got two Omegas and they banish the thing from your hand, and then with the other one they put it back in your grave so you don't get it.
Mm-hmm. So if he starts doing that, it'd be a dick move. I wouldn't be surprised. That's what he just goes into another Omega right now. With his fucking $5,000 deck.
Nope.
Another Minerva? No, no. Oh, cast.
Fair enough. No, I just wanted to put you face down.
Yeah, you can only use each effect of Minerva once per turn, so.
Oh, yeah. Cool. That makes it balanced.
Sure. Sure. Let's go with that.
I still don't get how she went from a level 3 to a rank 4. Level 3 tuner.
I guess we could do that whenever he's on. I just record whenever it's convenient. Again? Wow.
He's the one to feed him for damage juggler back. Well, don't tell him, because isn't it optional?
That's annoying that he keeps doing that.
You can target, so he could have put the juggler back, but...
This duel's already annoying. Well, I could do the play again. So I can go ahead and banish Cloak and get me another summon. Give me another boots, special summon. Normal summon, special summon, XE. But pop the Minerva. Target itself, target Minerva. Pop. It would go player turn priority because we both go off. So he would go first, in which he would mill 3 and I have nothing on the field. And then I would resolve my summon.
Cool.
Yeah, so.
So you can pop here.
Alright. Go ahead and get me the boots.
Slush some if I have another Phantom Knight monster. And then Cloak gets me a Phantom Knights. That actually might be good to give me one of them. Yeah, I guess I'll go ahead and do Boot Effect too.
Phantom Knights don't have a spell yet, do they?
I believe they have some spells, they're just not that good. Like, that's the problem.
Yeah. I don't think they had any.
Sword would be pretty good to get. Or Fog Blade. But what am I negating? Nah, I guess.
Oh, yeah, they have the Phantom Spear.
Yeah, they have like a spear or something. It's like, yeah, eh.
That's their only one.
I'm gonna summon. Special summon. You two. Going to you again. My friend.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
Target itself and Nerva. Oh, Nerva. And my...
Nerva.
Nerva. Fact, you chain. Perfect optional or mandatory? Destroyed by opponent. Okay, you can, so. Back to Manera. Yes or no, it's optional. Because, okay, so go ahead. You are chain link 2. Probably come priority of chain. My effect was off. Your Minerva chains. Yep. So you're gonna mill 3, pop. I have nothing, and then I resolve my summon.
Nice. No, oh, you would have got a pop as well.
Yep. 1, 2, 3. Was that 3?
Yeah, that was 3. Okay. Juggler, soul. No. You need to resolve before he gets that juggler. Because it doesn't matter too much, but...
And... He's absolutely nervous timing, so he would just start a separate chain after I resolve my summon. Yeah. Alright. So these guys are now level 4. Exceed you 2 into, of course, my big BP rebellion. Use my effect. You 2. That. I'll go up to 35.
Nom nom nom.
And then I'll just go ahead and... Did you pay the 1,000 for a trick, clown?
No, he didn't.
Pay 1,000 for a clown.
The money says so, though, but next set's gonna be a floodgate set. Do you guys think at some point they'll get hit on the list?
Yeah. They're kind of in the pool of too generic plays. You know, they're being splashed in too much anything, and it's going to start losing Konami money with them being a non-archetypal cash cow. They're just a whole bunch of commons and stuff, so it's going to be losing Konami some money. Konami don't want to lose no money.
I saw a picture the other day. It was of Towers, and it said,
"Wow, he actually plays JD." That shocked the hell out of me. Pay 1,000. Now, if I chain this, it'll protect me from being destroyed, right? For 1.
Yeah.
For 1 wipe. So everybody else die. Wow. And usually when you see this deck, they don't play JD. Yeah. Because they totally thought JD's effect once per turn was like, nah. He could activate it as many times as he fucking wants. gamed right here. It was a good duel. I put up a good fight, but I'm probably going to get gamed right here. Especially since I know he plays JD and I haven't seen a single JD mill. Yep, here we go. Here we go. Yep. All three JDs? Skill is trash? Sack the shit out of me? There we go. This fucking skill is trash. I swear to God. I swear to God, I hate skill is trash so much. It's like, wow. He did pay the 1,000.
Yeah, so I saw a picture of towers and it said on it, unaffected by everything except Konami.
Did they make so many fucking shits? Maybe you can maybe explain this to me. Is that Shadow Chat? That was Shadow Chat. What the fuck are you doing on here? So the Megazord says that it's unaffected by other card effects as long as it has four Xe materials, right? Except for your Super Quantum, right? Yeah. How was he affected by Ultimate Falcon?
What the which effect? The lower by 1,000.
Yeah.
I don't think he should have been. Did he have four different materials?
Yes, he did. I don't know. I don't know what the hell was going on. I also had six, and he was still adding cards from his deck to his hand.
Maybe it's just broke.
He just got silent. He's just like, I don't know.
It's got to be broken then, right?
Sure sounds broken to me. I got all this revival. I don't get, like, none of it. Like, I got, like, Depro?
I wouldn't trust them.
Yeah, I was wondering what was going on. What's that on paper? The deck seems fine. Maybe I should run, like,
yeah, it shouldn't have been affected, and he shouldn't have been able to add cards. So that means the Super Quantum's just not working properly, not scripted right.
I guess. I can't add you. You give me a Phantom Knight spell or trap, and you just increase me. So I guess I'll go ahead and send you to the graveyard, then use your effect to banish you. I wanted to get Cloak, but I guess you can't get Cloak with Cloak. That'd be cheap. So I'll get my gloves, and I'll lay my hands on you.
You don't want to catch these hands.
You can catch these hands.
He's out of there. He doesn't want to catch those hands. He saw the hands, and he was like, nah, I'm not catching them.
Morphages? Yeah, that deck is BS. That deck is hate incarnate.
It's programmed wrong at the minute as well. You don't have to tribute, which makes them even more broken.
That's so stupid. I swear to God, like, they're pro. GG?
I
know, GG. I haven't started doing yet, GG.
Rock Owen.
Wow. Great hand.
Number generator is still doing its work.
Mm-hmm. Well, you run the Dark Greffer, so if we can go ahead and get him, that'd be great. Oh, no. I don't want to build this deck. I'm so sick and tired of that deck. I faced that deck like 5 times yesterday. So sick and tired of that deck. You know how fucking straightened it is when you fucking summon that Megazord and it just gets tribute off because of fucking...
Yeah. I know.
Shit's so annoying.
Trust me, I know. I had a 9 material one and it just gets tributed. 9 separate different name materials.
So sick and tired of seeing that deck. Why is there a calculus? Why is there a calculus 5? That is a good fucking question. None of my teachers told me this. High school nor in, you know, community college. They just said calculus 3, and that's it. No one told me shit about this, but yeah, I gotta take calculus 4. But I think that's the highest calculus I had to take. I even looked at my master's degree, and
well, yeah, I'm pretty fond of the Amorphage because of the new one that says your opponent can't tribute cards. It's very nice, Kaiju, Monarchs.
So let's go ahead and take that back row. That back row is nothing, then I might be able to pull something off. So I'm going to go ahead and Foolish, send Cloak, Banish, get me. He's saying, you got a response? Phantom Knights. You chose the deck. Vanish. Get me the boots.
I swear all these guys are like named off like the basic like armor and weapons you get at the start of an RPG.
Mm-hmm.
Like your torn robe and your just your shitty items in general. Your broken sword.
Yep.
Your rugged gloves.
And some of the back is level 4s.
This is going to be so confusing if you didn't read it. Especially when you go into a rank 4.
So I gained that.
1,037.
And then attack you for 25. Which is not bad. That was not a bad play. That's a tough one. That's a tough one. Just like a good chunk of Yu-Gi-Oh! Right now, it just seems like whoever goes first. Whoever goes first and gets set up first, because Infernities can go off and set them multiple barriers. Like, are we talking full power Infernities? Like, what Infernities are we talking about? Synchro, full power, XCs? How many barriers do they have? How many, you gotta specify what Infernities we're talking about. So we're talking about full power Infernities? Like I said, it goes down on who's first, because I've assumed that a nice chunk of, so it's an honest type deal. Cut you in half. And gain that half. So my value is good. Like the morphages, can't they stop you from like what? Don't they have one that's like you banish, shit gets banished?
Yeah. Oh, great. They've got one that says your shit gets banished, one that says your opponent can't chain cards. One that says your opponent can't tribute cards.
Yep.
One that says your opponent can't activate spells or traps. Well, it says your opponent. All of these effects are neither player except Amorphage cards.
So you talk on target on base of monster your opponent controls. You cannot see something. So I'm set.
Mm-hmm.
I think he might have this duel then, because I cannot get rid of none of this.
Relying on him being a retributor. Okay. Yeah. Unless you get an MST.
There's no MST in this deck.
Oh dear. Twin Twister.
There's no Twin Twister in this deck.
Oh dear.
None of that back No, I wish. So I think he might have it because I'm just locked out of my extra deck, because that's totally what I like about Monarchs, is being locked out of my fucking extra deck where I can't duel.
Why didn't you play anything and get rid of floodgates and shit?
Because I'm just testing the consistency of the deck and its plays. Okay. I didn't anticipate that shit was going to get hit the fan like this.
Wait, what color was that? The spell card.
Which one? This? The new one?
Yeah. Spirit of the Monarch. Never seen that. Oh no, I have. I've seen the effect, I just hadn't seen the art. The double MST kind of dealio. It's kind of like awesome. Twin Twister.
Twin Twister. I said, I'm already kind of sick and tired of Monarchs. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and scoop it up. I got nothing. I got nothing to handle this. Sure. Whatever.
I think Twin Twister would be a pretty good card. Because you can also ditch a Phantom Knight and then get a search from it or whatever.
I said I'm already sick and tired of Monarchs. That's pretty sad to say. They haven't even come out yet and I'm already sick of them.
named Twin Whirlpool. I just dubbed Twin Twister.
Twin Twister. Oh, wait, did it get renamed?
I'm glad that I'm not playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Like that anymore. Because now if I just duel against Sakyeth Monarch's Lucky Me, I'm in extra deck and making it so I can't play Yu-Gi-Oh! I can just quit! Like, going to a tournament and dealing with that struggle. Sure. I'll kick your butt forever, Epic.
Unless you do Trish with Affinity and all that power, and no.
They'll just fucking Trish your hand out. That's all they'll do is just Trish the living shit out of your hand. Oh, what a great hand once again. God, my luck is showing, isn't it?
I'll do.
Okay. So you're playing some coin toss sacky shit. Alright. Sure. Something way luck based.
Sasky Sap, what the hell is this?
I don't know. It looks like a coin flipping deck.
Oh.
So it's yeah.
The luck deck. I've seen this.
Yu-Gi-Oh! Is already too luck based. So, fuck that shit.
It's not even good, even if you get good luck.
So. The only this card when you run it has six or more cards and your hand is two or less. You toss a coin color, right? You draw five cards. Call it wrong to keep your next turn. Wow, that's annoying. He went plus like hella. He went plus like the hellas. Keep on getting fucking mathematician. I remember dinner is too strong.
Yeah, I know, right? At least that's a card you want in your hand.
Mm-hmm. I'm already getting used to this deck's plays, especially since they all open up the same. Of course. What's its name? This nigga's all up in my hand. Ah, come on! See, and that's why Minecraft should be fucking at fucking one.
Well, wow.
That's so annoying. That's why Minecraft should be at one.
What are the odds?
Picked everything out of my fucking hand and got in my grill. Like, fucking limit this card, I swear.
At least they're not too bad in the grave.
Go ahead. So you roll and die, and the results apply one of the results.
Yep.
Two. Your opponent discards a card. That's annoying.
Really?
I don't really need the limit reverse.
MST on a dice roll.
Yeah. Can I chain or no?
Yeah, you can chain. Right?
I'm not sure. I think I have to. Doesn't target, so I don't think I can chain. Yeah,
oh, maybe not. Target. Okay.
That's what I was thinking, because when I read it, I was like, I didn't
read it. I just thought it was MST with a dice roll. That was my B. Hey, it doesn't work. Takes a thousand.
That's annoying. I was hoping to have that burial.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. He is just getting... just sat luck-sacking me. Of course.
Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a skill-based game.
Yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a skill-based game. I should have chained. I can chain, can I? Can I chain? No, I still can't. I can target.
All these damn coin flips and dice.
All these fucking coin flips are fucking me up. I swear to God, I'm getting fucked up by mind crushing coin flips. Like, this is fucking ridiculous. This is actually ridiculous. I'm being fucked up because of luck. Still annoying. If you could call it that. I'm able to do shit this entire duel.
He hasn't had a... oh, he had one bad roll with the... okay, that's two now. He's had two negative effects compared to his, like, good ones.
Oh, a whole bunch of good ones.
Yeah.
Seriously, that time wizard though. I mean, at least I get Armageddon Knight back to my hands. It's not terrible, but still. Still is already getting annoying. Five. Stroke monster, bone control, sound controlling monster, so. One hand, destroy one card you control. I'm getting fucked up by Time Wizard.
Waiting for that Ancient Dragon Wombo combo.
Oh, the humanity. I'm getting fucked up by fucking Time Wizard. You forgive me on my Armageddon Knight back. My boots. Two swords and a fog blade. So.
Ha, got him.
Got him!
That machine is brutal.
He's like, no! Yeah, now you gotta deal with all the nightmare. Oh, he's not going to attack into me? That's a surprise. Alright. So, I don't know what that last card is. Maybe I do. No, I don't, because he already played another one of this. This is, he probably set the gamble, so I don't know what this card is. That's gamble. I don't care about this. I don't care about none of this. So I think I'll just go ahead and do my play. Yeah, just go into him. You can go ahead and pop himself and pop that Ordeal of the Traveler. Yeah. Because that's obviously Gambler, which it's like when I have six cards. Yeah. It's kind of a trash card, really. It's just good. Like it could be good in early game, but still, it's kind of a trash card. Oh, Ordeal wrong, didn't I? Ordeal. YouTube back. Now, what do I want to go into? This card battles an opponent's monster. You can flip a coin and call it, you destroy the monster. I could just equip myself with the blade. With the Phantom Sword.
Mm-hmm.
Or I could just make myself unaffected with Thanatos.
Yeah, you could do that. But you've got so many swords, I reckon. Two swords.
Yeah.
You can deal a lot of damage right now.
So that's 31. Yep, 31.
And then an extra 800, 39.
I'm going to equip Yubel with the sword and attack with Yubel.
Oh, yeah.
So either way, you're dead. Whether you get your effect or not, just depends on whether you destroy my sword or not. Just do. My foe has that requires one monster. Cross the coin, call ahead, I draw a card. Alright, so. I guess it doesn't matter the order. Well, I guess it does, so. I guess this is a change to this. I don't know. Wow. Get wrecked. 600?
That's what you get.
600. Wow, Yubel actually has attack. I have 800 attack, so strong.
Please, no.
What? No, you take. I don't believe Yubel does battle damage. No, Yubel does do battle damage.
Wow.
Yeah, so first
200.
Take 200. Then take 600. Yes, Yubel actually attacked the risk.
Have you ever seen the day? No, Ultimate Nightmare does damage for attacking.
Mm-hmm. Woo! And you were only 600. So did you get it right?
The damage of them on the field, not on the...
No, it's current attack. No, put damage equal to that monster attack. No. Not original. It's current. And then 31. Fuck, I lose everything because of these fucking machines.
Oh, you could have made him down to 100.
Yeah, if I would have activated my sword.
It doesn't matter because it wouldn't have killed anyway.
I don't trust these machines.
Watch him get to your opponent draws a card.
discard a card, your opponent discards a card, draw a card, your opponent draws a card, destroy one monster, your opponent controls, and destroy this card. So I've activated this on this. Nah, I don't care if he kills the Dark Rebellion. Go ahead. So, roll that die. Let's see how lucky you get. One! Discard a card, bitch.
Come on, another one.
Six, destroy this card. Damn.
Okay, that's good.
Your luck has run out, Yugi boy.
Sets dice jar.
Gets destroyed.
Dice jar wouldn't be able to kill you anyway. I think the max it does is 6,000.
Nibsonia's left nipple. Oh, yeah.
Damn.
Nibsonia's left nipple. Damn. How did you not have that in my hand? So luck-based. The duel's annoying so much luck. That's kind of annoying. Kind of annoying, I must say. That's how lucky you were getting.
Says you're on Tour of Doom.
Alright. Well, we're like an hour into the stream. Didn't you say you were going to do something with Yubel? Because if you want to work on it, like I said, that deck has just been... just takes too much setup. Like, we might have to, like, remake a new UBLXs and not rely on the level modulating cards because they're just too inconsistent.
Yeah.
The deck's just too inconsistent. I gotta get level modulating cards, sending cards, and revival cards. It's way too much.
Hmm. Oh man, you can make Yubel Exodia Exe. Could summon Lord Exodia?
I guess, but wouldn't you rather have Summon Lord put in that work than...
Yeah, I guess. If you get Exodius as well. If you get the win with Exodius' effect.
If you win with Exodius, Exodius too strong.
Please nerf Exodius. To be honest, it's kind of plausible, right? Oh, no, wait, you have to send all five with his effect, don't you?
Oh. New.
Yeah, they have to be sent there by his effect.
I meant... Oh. I was returned from the Dark Dimension. I just tucked that. I know it's Dark Dimension. Just tuck that in. Escape from the Dark Dimension. I was like, what the fuck? Yeah. Ticky ticky, yeah, not bad. I'll probably drop cast down to one and I'll put in a Karagorgon. There we go. That's looking mighty powerful, I must say. I haven't used Dark Refer once in this entire fucking at all. Dark Refer has literally done nothing all day. He's twiddling his thumbs like, yeah, I'm still here. If you want me to be here.
It's not like I want to be played or anything back.
My fiends are syndrome.
Greffa the syndrome.
Yeah.
you've exhausted so many decks.
Yep. There's new Xyz, but... because it really doesn't need to exceed at times. Seeing as I would like to throw more exceed-based stuff in here, that'd be nice.
Ravenous Tarantula looks pretty crazy.
It does. It looks like... was that number 77?
No, that's the Seven Sins. The rank 10 one, number 35. The one that boosts all of your monsters by...
What's so scary about it?
No, I didn't mean the artwork, I meant the effect.
Oh, yeah. I think you're the artwork. I'll say no, that's not the Scary Spider. Scary Spider 77.
Yeah. I don't that's like the artwork on the other two.
That's the thing. That's the... Kill it.
77 is amazing.
Kill it. All right. So, I mean, I guess we could start off here. Like I said, this version is not working anymore. It's really not.
Mm.
You got to get the sending. Then you got to get the
Mirror Ladybug. Is that any good? I don't remember. The one that copies the level.
Oh, at least one person monster. You have no monsters in your graveyard. Nope.
Oh, no. That's atrocious. I remembered it because it hasn't been played in a long, long time. And I just remembered it being a level one that could copy the level or something else. I didn't remember that.
Yeah, Exodus. Why would I want to put my shit in the graveyard back into the deck? That's terrible.
It is.
If we can think of any more rank 10 base plays, I wouldn't mind taking these out, because these guys aren't necessary. Yeah. You're just being
cute. Go a bit more turbo, run the triple chicken game.
Chicken game, the pseudo space.
And also that triple chicken game, you could get your life point difference up, and then Ravenous Tarantula becomes a beast.
I think we should go with that instead of going with this
one. And starts as well.
Okay.
Maybe just keep one of the Mound of the Bound.
But I love the Mound of the Bound.
And so probably take out the Earthbound Immortal too.
No! What's hello? Earthbound Immortal is like fucking great. Like, you're crazy.
It doesn't fit the turbo. He's too slow.
No, you're too slow. Oh, burn.
Wow.
I went there. You're like, I'm leaving. I don't even get any stuff. I still don't like Tragodia. I guess I'll keep him in here for just a rank 10 place. So, is there any other level 10 monsters that we can actually do with? Like, have you not seen how fucking Earthbound Immortal
I didn't see the first. The stream where you put him in, and that was that a stream or a video? I don't remember. It was a stream.
And yeah, I think for some reason it's always Omega that duels his deck, and I always smack him in the face because it just mounted the bound with Kaka.
Yeah.
Every single time, it's hilarious. I don't need none of these other Earthbounds. I only need one Kaka because I can send it to the graveyard and I can revive it. Unless it's a better Earthbound. Because now, since I'm not running it specifically for fiends, is there any other Earthbound Immortal that's better than him?
The spider one can take control of an opponent's monster.
I'm looking at all.
I don't remember how it does it.
This card destroys monster on battlefield damage. And no, but you're not going to be strong enough. You can be in that direct attack.
The lizard kills everything when it dies.
This card is drawn by card effect, except that's not pretty sure. All cards on the field. Holy crap.
The bird is pretty good.
The whale.
He's the one that can skip your opponent's battle phase and burn your opponent.
I think the monkey was good.
I don't remember what the monkey does. I think he sucks.
You contribute one other monster instead of this card and put half damage to your opponent. Half is bleh. Shadow monster target, triple monster, and target with a monster upon control can take control of that target.
Oh, that's pretty bad.
Then you're the weakest one, right?
Yeah.
I'll be one of them. This card is only guitar 3.
The top right bird, the yellow one's pretty good, I think. I don't remember what he does.
This is the card leads the pillar tap by its own effect. Destroy as many face up monster opponent controls as possible. And if you do, like 800. Yeah, I think I'd rather go with you. I really only need one of you, because I can send you to graveyard because you're dark and then revive you through all my revival cards. And you're level 10, right? Yeah, obviously, I typed in level 10 and you showed up. Obviously, you're level 10. Duh. I don't like you because I don't like putting my shit back. I guess we could consider you, but I don't like putting my shit back.
You could put in a Gandora X.
The fuck is a Gandora X?
Search it. It's not level 10. Gandora, like the dragon.
Respell it.
It's not level 10.
Oh. And do I like that? I think it's
oh,
on here.
They not added it. Oh, that sucks. It's the X version of that Gandora. Basically, you tribute monster to summon him, and you summon him, however, and then it destroys all monsters on the field, deals damage to your opponent equal to the highest attack on the field, then gains attack equal to that damage. So if you have the Malefic Cyber End, it will deal 4,000 to the opponent, clear their field, and have 4,000 attack.
I didn't know he was 10. And yeah, I guess he is 10. I'm not going to do all that.
No. What? Who can, like, change level to 10? Because the 10s themselves are pretty underwhelming.
Mm-hmm. Let's see, is there a monster that can change this level to 10? I don't think so. At the top of my mind, I don't think so. It's not a lot of standalone level 10s, to say the least. If I ran no back row, he would be fine. But I can only special summon if I control no hard spell traps in my graveyard like all the other ones. A wind zombie, you don't say that every day. Time Lord cards. Could.
Maybe. Maybe like one Metaton.
Yeah, Metaton. Since card deck could control no monsters, you can. No,
I think Cephalon's too hard to summon in this deck.
Yeah, I can't summon in this deck. So I can just normal summon Medion. And return everything. It's not terrible. I don't know, what do you think? Medion or Trag? Did you find any level modulating guys?
I'm looking.
Probably put something like in here. Probably spells. On the back corner too. I'm not sure if I need Trag. Guess Trag is fine for reviving it and having more rank 10 plays.
Yeah. I like Trag. He is a bit slow though.
Yeah. Because I do not have a lot of 10s. That's the problem. I got Metal Reflex, Lime, Trag, Silipiscu, and Malefic Cyber End. So, those are my. Oh, and Yubel. Duh.
So, yeah, but.
You think I should run, like, more 10s, like Medion or something like that? You can, like,
yeah,
summon Medion
maybe
and revive.
I'm looking through cards that can change the level. Hell, we could go down the Gagaga road.
But he can only go up to 8, though.
Yeah, but with the other Gagagas, like.
No.
But I don't know if we want to do that. Not seeing a lot of promise here.
Oh, good. I guess I'll just leave it for like that for right now. So
putting them spiders.
Yeah. Don't need you anymore. Spiders. 30 for you. No. 30. Got his number already. What was that again? Oh, 36. I'm sitting here and keep guessing. Can I get it right? 31.
35. It's 35.
34. Keep guessing.
The other one. I'm in 077. The other one is for 84.
Yeah. It's fine.
I think probably the strongest one out of all of them is that one. The rank 10.
35. 84.
77. Oh, 77.
Is there anything else I'm missing?
Maybe we want to run another of the 10.
No. 35.
Yeah. Because that could pretty easy OTK, I feel.
Alright. Let's go ahead and try it. I need to tweak the consistency of the sending. I might need to.
Man, lots of people play Exodius in the ranks index.
Of course.
It's yeah, a great with Yubel as well.
Yeah. With Yubel? Like, what? That's
yeah, crazy. But I reckon it's not too bad because you can... you don't have to use it.
I can keep sending all of them and can't keep sending Yubel and stuff.
Sometimes the rank 10 plays are just stronger than the Yubel ones.
No, yeah, you got my terraforming and my mounds of the bound, so that should be fun. Just go ahead and summon that Malefic Sovereign and start fucking this lady up.
Up stuff. Oh, okay. You're going to Finn first, I guess. That makes sense.
Yeah, interest. I mean, my plays are kind of set with this hand. I'm not going to do the chicken game for right now.
Yeah, but if you upstart into a Man of the Bound right now, you're going to wish you kept that terraforming.
Better not. Yeah. I'd say I better fucking not. Could already get dirty with it, but I guess I'll go ahead and send you Bell. Could already fucking get the Earthbound Immortal set up and start just fucking him up with Mount of the Bound. Oh, Mount of the Bound. So powerful with the level 10s. How many times have I just sat there with Mount of the Bound and Yubel and just stalled the fuck out? As long as my Mounded Bound is there, I should be okay. Okay. God. And I'm just gonna summon another level 4, make a cast stealth, spin back my Mounded Bound. That would suck. What you doing? Okay. Turn defense, that's fine.
I swear there's a fairly recent card that could change all your monsters to the level of another one.
Hmm.
I can't remember for the life of me what it was.
Galaxy Queen's Light?
No. It was a newer card. It might have been a monster.
Alright, well, you have fun looking for that.
Wait.
You take 1,000. You take 1,000. Perfect. I always forget about that effect. Swear to God, I do. So, you can keep sending monsters, but I'm going to keep burning you for 1,000. And then I can just go ahead and activate this Call of the Haunted, summon you Bell, XC these two, and then BAM, hit you with that spider dome. Another 1,000. And then you float it up. Alright, so that's 1,000 attack. The spider's so powerful. All my monsters gain the difference. And Armageddon Knight's gonna be so ripped. Armageddon Knight's gonna be like, sterile. Butt ton of revival. A butt ton.
Oh my god, this is gonna so annoy me. What is the name of this damn card? I swear there was a card that let you change all your monsters' levels to one of your other monsters.
Say, that was true. I'd hella put that in here. Yeah. Oh, speeds. I did not know it was speed rights. Oh, oh snap. I'm gonna get fucking crystal messed. I'll get fucking destroyed. Is crystal mess on here yet?
Probably, because Shining Victories came out.
Okay, so.
Normally DN at it when the whole set is.
So, if he summons crystal mess, I'm gonna get fucking wrecked. He's gonna run over my beloved Cyran and be like, no! That'd just be terrible. You looking in that extra deck? Are you just going to B-Rose me? If you do, I deserve it. Find it yet?
No, still looking. Killing me. I mean,
it sounds like a simple monster. Just target a monster on your side of the field, and this monster level becomes that level. That'd be great. Oh,
shit, I remember. It was the freaking super quantum. But I'm pretty sure you have to target
a super quantum, the rabbit.
You do.
I believe it has to be a super quantum, yeah.
It does, I just looked it up. That was the card I was thinking of, though. I knew there was something that changed all your monsters, too.
Let's say, if it wasn't super quantum, that'd be some shit. I'd be loving that. I'd be like McDonald's up in here. Except I don't eat McDonald's. Make tops level 4. Yeah. Oh, sync 5? Yep. No idea.
The badminton racket? Whatever it is.
Sword. Okay, no. Sure. Is that what that thing is?
The other one, I think so. Because it's got like a badminton. Like. It's not a ball. What the hell do they call it?
I don't know.
With the weird tails on. Shuttle, that's it. Boom.
Alright, I can go ahead and chain. Then those, yeah, sure. So. Got rid of my failed spell. No! Could he actually play Shock Surprise?
Well, then what? That was a surprise.
That was a surprise. It really was. I knew I wasn't going to sit on that for long. Just wondering why he's going to Sword, and Sword couldn't handle the situation, so obviously he had something to handle the situation. No, I got Tear. Now I just gotta worry about Clearwing, because I know Clearwing's gonna fuck me up.
Mm-hmm.
And Yubel was actually destroyed because of Man the Bound was on the field to protect Yubel from being destroyed anymore. So I chain, I summon Yubel, your card will destroy my two cards.
Simultaneously.
Yep. So I'm good.
So, you know, pretty good thing he hit that Man of the Bound too.
He got too thirsty for it and it was over.
Well, you would have kept the Malefic if he didn't, so.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, does it? It says destroy two cards, right? Not destroy two spells.
So that's true. Banish two, target as many cards as you can. Yeah. So you banish two targets, too.
Oh, but you couldn't have got the Malefic if the Mound was on there anyway.
Wow, I just keep getting revival cards. It's ridiculous.
Hmm. They might not be as good in this deck.
All that revival?
Hmm.
So much revival, I can just keep, that's all I keep drawing. I need my filth spell. If you want to run fucking Pathfinder just so I can get my filth spells as soon as possible, quick as possible.
Oh. Quick? The card's so slow.
But I'm clearly, I don't have any filth spells right now, I just have revival. I can go ahead and attribute it, get my filth spell, then special summon my Malefic.
Hmm. We could go even more turbo on those pseudo spaces.
Like banish the cop, is it till the end of the turn or is it just period?
Seeing as we have chicken games. It's till the end of the turn, but I meant seeing as we have chicken games.
Oh, if I had chicken game. There's not much I could really do right now. Just kinda take it slow. No. Like I could summon Armageddon Knight with revival, Armageddon Knight send something to activate another revival, but all I have is Castell and Cowboy. I do not know why it's fucking cowboy. I should probably put like Diamond Dire Wolf.
Hmm.
I'm actually like a little bit terrified of clearing, especially the way that this deck can pump it out. Clearing would just destroy me. And just go ahead and fucking negate my wiping.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know you did that. This card is integrated by you can target one speedrun monster. Target one of your banished speedrider monsters and add it to your hand. Yep.
I swear these cards were meant to be like kids' toys. Why is this one just a sword?
It's a toy sword. No, this is blatantly a sword. Say, so don't do it. Don't do it. Don't you dare fucking do it. Don't you dare fucking synchro summon another one and go into infinity. I'll kill you. I love a terraforming right now. Another mound of the bound. So is that all you're gonna do right now? Yeah, Dark Arthur. Awesome. No, there's just nothing I should do. It's like literally nothing. I'm going to have to go back and work on this deck some more. I think I have too much revival, not enough set up. When a royal monster is added regret to your hand, you can special summon the monster. Oh, okay. I guess that's for your spell card. That ambulance ride.
Wow.
No fucks one. It's going extremely slow. Oh, why are you still setting your shit? I don't know if I want his life points to be higher than mine or lower than mine. Like, hasn't been decided. Yeah, there's a mountain down.
It doesn't matter because the difference can be either way.
Yeah, but I'm still keeping even because I keep increasing and decreasing.
Yeah.
The gap's not widening, yeah. If this was a fucking Diamond Dire Wolf, which it will be, then I could win Armageddon Knight, send Summoner Dark Reaper, Diamond Dire Wolf, destroy, and summon Ultimate Nightmare, and then Mount of the Bound.
Yeah.
That would have been great. No, it's just your opponent controls. I was hoping that it's just put face at monsters, period.
Wait, what did he say if it was Diamond Dire?
Diamond Dire, destroy Ultimate Nightmare. I mean, Terran Currents
and Ultimate. Because it can destroy Beasts, Swing Beasts, and Beast Warriors on your side.
I destroy himself, and then I destroy a card on the field.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. I thought you meant destroy the Yubel and his set. I was tripping.
Yeah. That would be tripping. He keeps on setting shit. I mean, there's really no point in me doing anything right now. Actually, you know what? There is. I can start getting dirty already. I think I'll go ahead and start getting dirty. Activity call. Again.
Man, something that would copy levels would be so nice, because even just being able to copy that Terra, you could make the level 11 spider, the rank 11 spider.
Oh, I gotta take it a turn slower now, but I still have the place.
You got plenty of revival.
No, I don't care if it gets rid of Terra right now. And I'm about to step into the dirtiness. We're about to get dirty in here. Mm-hmm. Wow, he's actually... How many fucking ambulance rides do you play? It's like he's doing something. Like, you don't even know what I'm planning. Like, I'm going to kind of space that, because I'm going to hold on to this mountain to the bound, and you're about to get destroyed. I'm about to get dirty up in here. And they're going to show us that I wanted a dirty Yubel decks.
You know, oh, that yeah. April Fool's deck, the defense one. Where you try and kill them by them attacking into your monsters.
No. Not that dirty. But dirty.
Because I was just saying, this new trap card, Daunting Pose, that lets you double your face-up monster's defense, current defense, not original. So you can D2, and then you can use Daunting Pose.
I like nothing good. Yeah, I would have Diamond Dire Wolf right now. Sure.
This seems more just like Roid.
Mm-hmm. I said there's really no reason to go into either one of these two. So, well, Diamond Dire could have won. Diamond Dire pops. Ultimate Nightmare. So, yep. I went to myself, Diamond Dire needs to go in here yesterday. Yes. I'm getting Knights to serve your purpose. Next turn, we get the dirty on. Especially since he, for some reason, can't figure out how to handle Ultimate Nightmare. And you'd be like, Daniel, no. And I'd be like, yes. Mound to the bound. Obviously, I know it's just Scarecrow, so...
Here we
go. Haunted, and fail.
Direct 2,500.
Mm-hmm. Can't target me with your Swiss Scarecrow? Because that card does target. Can't. Air effect. Wipe, but I'll keep my Acetylpiscu because it's level 10. Damn, it's so dirty. Go. I feel so dirty. But yeah, and you're like, oh, take that out, Earth Venom, what up? No. And this is how I was being Omega. There's about one or two strong. Show your shit, go.
May as well be first time to
Seriously, I told you, this deck is dirty.
Hey, you could just make an Earthbound Immortal Yubel deck.
I mean, it's pretty much what this deck is, right?
Yeah, but without just one Earthbound Immortal, and you could run the amazing counter trap and the Harpy's Feather Duster.
Then I can go back and look at it. Damn.
He's like, God damn it. Oh, that feels so good.
Yeah, take a look at the Earthbound Immortal spell and traps. It's super good.
Take a look at the what?
The Earthbound Immortal spell and traps. I mean, not for this deck, but if you were going to make an Earthbound, not those ones. The that one, yeah, the trap you were on, and that Whirlwind. Earthbound Wave and Earthbound Whirlwind.
Damn! That's a dick move. I could. I really could make an Earthbound Yubel deck. I would have to see an Earthbound deck some more, though. Am I running this correctly?
Oh, you don't want that yet. Yeah, you're running it pretty right. They normally run Molosseum of the Emperor.
Oh, so I can tribute summon them?
Yeah, about yeah. Tributes.
So I think my revival method's actually pretty good.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, we can make it more of a version of that deck.
And that the other spell lets you add them from your grave to your hand.
I don't want them in my hand, though.
Yeah. But if you're playing Mausoleum, you would.
No.
Oh, man. Mausoleum, you're paying 2,000 to summon. That makes a huge life point.
Different to the spider.
Yeah. That could be pretty good. Especially as your Earthbound Immortal is going to attack directly, so you can give them the massive attack buff.
I'll go back to this for now. And then I'm debating on whether I should stick with him or go to a different Earthbound. I'm deciding a sec. Because I don't know how many Earthbounds
maybe
that
I could just stick with the blue guy you have.
Yeah. Still not sure if I like you either.
I think the upstarts and chicken games are good. I just don't think you really.
The problem is that I got to run more Earthbound cards now.
Oh, okay. We're making that now. Okay. I thought we were just editing the current one.
No, because everything else in this deck I'm happy with.
Okay. And so maybe just run.
I could probably drop the revival
one
down.
One of the bird and one of the whale in addition to that. Blue guy.
Okay. The bird. I said I would like to see an Earthbound deck. I should just go ahead and search up an Earthbound Immortal deck.
Yeah.
Earth. Double custom, really?
This guy. Isn't a good one.
No. What is Phantom of Chaos doing here? I don't understand where you're going with this. I don't understand like half these cards.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. That's not the ones I've seen. It's not a good deck, but.
What is Offering to the Immortals?
Oh, that's the one that lets you summon tokens.
Oh.
It's not good.
No, this is not a good deck. Clearly, no. I can't go to any videos, though. Because I do not want their videos being played in my stream. That would be bad. I think the deck profile I just saw was this one.
The mausoleum is good. For sure.
So, we should go with the mausoleum route.
Yeah, I think.
How many?
That's a good question. Maybe...
Should we still run chicken game? Or should we just
take I think we should run... No, I reckon chicken game's good. I think it should be only one Mound of the Bound and three...
Mound of the Bound's the best one. You'd not see how much work Mound of the Bound played in that duel.
I don't know. We're changing it up. I don't see... Mound of the Bound is good. I'm not doubting that. It's just if you have one...
But if they destroy it, then I have none.
Yeah, but... I don't know. Personally, I would run the one.
I don't even know the ratios of the freaking Earthbound Immortals and stuff like that. They figure that out.
I don't think we want too many, because these ones run quite a few. But you've got all the ditching. Like, they don't really run that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got the ditching and the revival, so I don't really need to run. And you can only have one Earthbound Immortal on the field. Exactly. So and
I think the three you have are the best three.
Okay. I just pitch them to the graveyard and revive them back.
Yeah. So maybe we don't need too many mausoleum. Maybe just one or two. Maybe two.
No, I only need one.
I think chicken game is pretty MVP.
I'll keep one. But the question is, am I running any of the Earthbound spell and traps?
Maybe one or two whirlwind.
Okay. And was there any other Earthbound cards that you run?
The trap is pretty good. The wave at the bottom.
This is so sharp. While you control it, I'm gonna get everything to destroy it. Alright, we can try that. So, like that?
Yeah, we can try that.
Alright. Shredek wise.
I think the Shredek's fine.
Alright, let's try it. Yeah, I'm not the boss thinking of that. That's why I'm not even, that's why I'm here live streaming. Because I am not going. That's why Lunar's here, not Stu, because Stu went.
He's like, yeah, I can join you. And he's like, oh, wait, I'm going to the sneak peek. Like, have fun.
Like, I don't want none of that. Anal warp. All right. Disgusting. Hello. It's not bad. As long as I'm getting Night Ghost. Oh no. Oh no.
You could run a Yubel God deck.
You mean the Yubel God deck?
Like, oh wait, is that already a thing?
What do you mean? I don't understand what you mean by.
Like with Ra, well, probably not Ra, but Obelisk.
How?
Like, because how Mound of the Bound, when it dies, it searches the Divine, but also the fact that you could run True Name, and you could run... You could use Armageddon or Grefa to pitch...
Pitch what?
What's his name?
Monsters?
No. The... the one... I have to search his name. You banish it, and then you look at the top five cards of your deck and put them back in any order from your grave. And then you can use True Name because you've seen what's on top.
Banish it and do that. What the fuck does that? Kaibaman or?
Oh, there he is. Absolute King Backjack.
Yeah, Backjack.
Top three cards.
This man is an anal wart. Playing this fucking deck. That's, and this is the reason why I don't like this deck, because it literally has one fucking play. One play, that's it. That's all it does.
Look up, there's a guy on YouTube called Ignoble Knight.
I know Ignoble Knight, and he hates me, because I hate Noble Knights. Yeah, he hates me.
Well, he plays it so much differently, and it works.
Well, that's all I'd be saying. This deck is boring to me.
It's the only play that's
shortest,
grubs
shortest deck on Daily Duels ever. One episode, that's all it got. And then I was like, nope, I don't like Noble Knights. Do I choose one, or does, or is it random? That's
it's random.
So. Sad thing is, I can still sack the shit out of them. Hurry up! Holy fuck, I hate this play. I'm already falling asleep. Yes, thank you. It is. Thank you. Glad someone agrees with me. It's boring. We already know the play. Everyone knows the fucking play, so hurry it up. You gonna play the Kaiser too? Just to be a cherry, dick cherry on top of your fucking asshole ice cream?
Your anal wall ice cream?
Mm-hmm. Where the fuck's your Excalibur? What the fuck is your Excalibur? Wow, that's so bad. I'd
rather have Calibur than Excalibur.
But targeting.
No, I didn't mean Calibur. I meant Gallatin. He should have picked Excalibur over Gallatin.
Nigga, fuck your White Castle. I hate White Castle. So you pop monsters, right? Don't you can touch them to target this card, then target one of the monster on the field to try to target this card, center, blah, 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 blah. Okay. It's debatable on what I should do.
Hmm.
I can go ahead and get Yubel set up, or I can go ahead and get the Earthbound set up.
You could get the whale.
What does the whale do?
He makes your opponent not have their battle phase and can burn your opponent every turn. For 1,200.
Hmm. It's debatable on who I want to send. It's obviously this fucking whirlwind ain't gonna be doing much.
Yeah.
Because they're just re-equipped, so... in the attack, can't be destroyed, and he didn't gain his life points, did he? No, didn't.
No, but it's not like he has to, so.
I guess that kind of answers my question. I should probably send you Bell.
He's a strong, independent anal wart. He doesn't need life points. I had my first driving lesson today.
Oh, you're learning how to drive?
Yeah.
More Madrat Boris action. Oh, what? Harold and Kumar go to White Castle on TV right now? And I said, I don't know. Maybe it's just because it was in Vegas. Because that was not, I was not impressed. Gotta get that Lance because he's afraid of back row. Ain't nothing back here. Mm-hmm. one monster. Your opponent cannot target monsters with dot attack. Alright. No card is equipped. You can pop a backer, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, on face up card on the field and destroy it.
Oh, face up.
You think I can bait him into being dumb?
Maybe.
I think I could probably bait him into being dumb.
Yeah.
He did forget Caliburn. To gain health.
Yeah, he seems like he's been pretty dumb lately. Depending on if he has a Noble Knight card in his hand. Actually, I'll still be fine because I can just play Mountain to the Bound and he can't do shit to me. So.
Yeah.
So, I want to see if he's going to be dumb. I'm going to summon Yubel. I want to see if he just jumps to conclusions and wants to pop my Yubel to Call the Haunted with his Dristan in main phase 2. Or you can just use his target's effect. Go ahead, use your effect.
So many ways to summon Terror. So many ways.
Yep, so many ways. Go ahead, pop me. Go ahead. You know you want to. You know you don't want to just leave me out of here. You can't even get around you, Belle. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Look at him thinking in main phase 2. He's just thinking. Sure. Terror? Now you're gonna equip and make me someone else's nightmare? Don't. You better not. I swear to God, if you do, you're gonna lose this duel.
Oh my God, that'd be fucking crazy if that's what he does.
I know he has a Forbidden Lance, but I don't know the other card in his hand. Nor do I know that set. So there's two unknown cards. Alright. Another round of down.
We maybe want to cut the whirlwind down to one.
Yeah, I don't even think it's that good right now. I really don't need it when I have Mounted the Bound. I don't give a shit about you back there. Maybe if I wasn't running Mounted the Bound. Still can't really deal with you, though. I think about maybe holding off for a turn, because I know he's probably just going to go ahead and pop my Terror and I get Ultimate Nightmare. And then play Mounted the Bound next turn. And then come after him. And if he ends up double popping, because she's going to die, even if you end up double popping, I still got more revival. So yeah, I'll just take it slow. I'm okay for right now. And kill that Dristan for me. You got Forbidden Lamp. I don't care. Yeah, you can't be destroyed because once per turn to Destiny, it's fine. So summon Ultimate Nightmare. Because I know you're gonna have to kill my Terror. But summon Ultimate Nightmare. Play that Mountain of the Bound. The Ultimate Nightmare is going to eat you up. You're going to be taking 37. Well, actually, your attack's been dropping because of Destiny. I've been counting the turns, though.
Not Destiny. Gallatin.
Yeah, Gallatin. I haven't even been counting the turns. What turn is this?
I think he's had one standby phase. This is going to be his second one.
Okay. Good.
This is why he needs to use counters.
Yeah. So now he's 33?
Yeah.
37. Okay. Upstart, sure. Pot. Sure. Another Forbidden Lance. Another Upstart. Oh, Breakthrough Skill. You gonna grab that Breakthrough Skill?
Breakfur.
Yep. Breakfur. So, pop me again. Ooh, this duel is kind of boring. Yep. That's obviously a birthday scam. Yes. Attack. Take 33. Let's go ahead and set that back down. Well, actually, you can play it. You would just be hitting your own monster. Or does it say opponent? Nope. Opponent. So yeah, you can't do it. Can't even activate it. So go ahead and take 33 for me. Yes. No, because you can't even activate. Yeah. Keep the breakthrough. Because you can't even play it. Target one face of effect monster your opponent controls, but you can't, so you can't even activate it. Yeah, I'm good. Go ahead. That's the sad thing is he still doesn't have fucking Excalibur. I mean, yeah, Excalibur. So I could literally make a Castell and spin him back. If I wanted to. Mm-hmm. Depends on how threatened I am. So you can't activate the Breakthrough Skill. I don't know what this stat card is. Knowing you, it'll probably just be an unforbidden land.
What skeleton's attack drop each?
Isn't it 200 every standby phase? 300. Yeah, so he's down to 31. Particularly, I would love to end this duel. Look at this. It's so dirty. I love not the ground. I really don't need the whirlwind at all. I really don't. Let me go back under the hood. It doesn't need to be an earthbound deck. It really doesn't. I would love to end this duel with that fucking spider, though. Freaking him.
Yeah. I'm gonna found attack directly.
I don't think I can.
Oh, in fact, even just getting Terra to that high attack.
Mm-hmm.
Really cool.
I don't have two level 10s right now. Yeah. I need Malefic Cyberman.
You got Revival.
All I got is Oasis and the Reverse, yeah. So I would need one more piece of Revival. Perfect. Yeah, one for Yubel and then one for the other monster, probably the Earthbound.
Or if you draw Malefic.
Yeah, or if I draw Malefic. Damn it, he's getting destroyed. Like, I love you, Mandelbound. All right, so he can only summon Noble Knight monsters. Can I switch some of the rest of turns up Noble Knight monsters? Trying to target 3 Noble Knight monsters. Sure. Wow, it's just you control. That's annoying. So that would be 3, right?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so you're gonna break these. Actually, if you break these kill me, I resolve in the graveyard, so I'll end up killing you. I'll go ahead and chain. Wait, are you talking field spell?
Yeah, he did.
Okay. Simultaneous destruction. Effect. Even if you break this skill me, you know it's when I resolve in the grave, so if you break this skill me and then hit me, you will die.
Mm-hmm. How often do you see 2 forms on the field?
Not very often. Come at me, bruh. Come on. because Yubel resolves in the graveyard.
GG.
2900. GG. So, Yubel's in grave. So, you take 2900. Yep, because I and at the end of demo step, I will be in the graveyard. True, GG. I got wrecked. I know, true.
That's true.
I know, he's like the first guy to not argue with me. All right, I think I want to stick with this guy because he's like 3,000. So,
fair enough. We didn't really get to test the earthbounds anyway, but
it's not necessary.
Yeah, well, it's not necessary. It was just an idea. It was an idea. It wasn't meant to be like a spin-off of this deck. It was meant to be like a...
an Earthbound deck. But this deck is just so much better.
Yeah.
Hello? I never noticed I wasn't running this card. What the fuck's wrong with me? Wow. Oh, I'm so bad. Wow, I'm fucking terrible. Alright, so... I would like to see more 10s. Possibly.
You could put Exodus in, I reckon.
Yeah, I could.
Just to see how it goes. If it is becoming too nuisance, putting everything back.
The only other thing I was thinking of was running the trains.
You could do the trains, I guess. Yeah. Right.
Should I try to train
it? Switch yard.
Mm-hmm.
Have we not had train Yubel yet?
No.
I kind of thought we had.
Nope. Revolving. Right, so I need to figure out the field spell ratio in this.
I reckon Man of the Bound down to 2 then.
Need that.
And I'm just out with chicken game.
So, how many field spell?
3 of Switchyard, I'd say.
Right. Then I need...
3 Express Knight.
Yeah. Knight, Express
Knight. 3 Derrickin. And some Ruffians. I think it's Dere.
Dere?
Dere is in I.
Dere. No.
It might be double R, I reckon.
Oh, it's a double R? Damn. This guy.
Just like a heavy freight train.
Yeah. Heavy. F? Thank you. Holy shit. Why is this so difficult?
It is. Oh, it's an E. Derrickane.
Goddamn. Derrickane. God.
Been reading that wrong for so long.
And then Ruffian.
Mm-hmm.
How many Ruffians should I run? What does Ruffian do again?
He searches your level 10.
Yeah, but I got my field spell.
And
for
also,
that.
You can summon him with the field spell.
That's just true.
Probably 2.
Mm.
And you can foolish him.
Mm. True. You're right. You smart. You loyal.
You <Khalid. laughs> Another one.
Another one.
Yeah, this could work. Wow, there can be some pretty interesting victories with the Earthbound Immortal and the Pain Gainer. Or, no, not the Pain, Ravenous Tarantula.
Mm-hmm.
I really want to see that. The Tarantula make the Earthbound, like, 6,000.
All right, let's try this, and then this will be the last little stream.
I'll try and draft, because I like my God's Yubel deck. I'm going to see if I can make it work on my own, in my own time.
All right, draft it up. It's just trains right now. That's all the trains.
Hey, you shouldn't be complaining. You got a good deck.
Okay. Oh,
that's fine.
That's fine. All right. I need to fix the freaking dark to dark ratio again. I fucked that up. I'm going to tell myself, fix that, fix that. Fix it, fix it, fix it, fix it, fix it. So I think I can just go this to this and make a Dora.
Yeah.
Now the question is, what the fuck is that monster? Should I make myself should I make myself unaffected now and attack into it or not? That's the question, because I feel like something sacky.
I think it'll be fine, but
just attack into it?
Yeah. God, this is where it's all my fault. Now we live in sure. This guy's a complete He realizes that just gets counteracted by it's level 4 or higher, isn't it? Not level. Mm-hmm.
Like, if that's what you want to do, sir.
I'm surprised he hasn't been complaining that your XZ isn't in defense yet.
Hold on. Holy shit. While your opponents are lower than your opponent, the equipped monster's original attack becomes 2400, while the equipped monster becomes 100. So, he's going to pay the 1,000, go up to 34, but then this will go off because his life points are his original attack. So, he goes to like 50 something?
Jesus Christ.
Holy shit. I'm going to use my effect.
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely. Detach, make myself unaffected. Barricane effect. Barricane effect. Destroy that. I'm like, holy shit. Get out of here. Calm the fuck down, nigga.
You're going to have to highlight that for him. There's no way he's going to read that.
Like, no.
Get out of here with that shit.
Seriously, like, hello? Damn. Remember when Injection Fray Lulu was banned?
Pretty broke.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm afraid of needles. No, I'm not. No. Oh. Back off. Step off.
You're dead as shit. His equip doesn't save him or anything, right?
No. He's just dead. So I quit if you want to, because I'm about to fuck you up next turn. I swear to God I will destroy you.
Tarantula, man.
I know, I am.
That tarantula will have 2,000, attack directly with that, and then the difference will be 4,000, so
you just discard a card, isn't it?
Yeah. Any card.
This is gonna be great. This is gonna be great. What a great way to end the stream and fucking just destroy you and make you have my fucking babies. Like,
oh god, the fact they're spiders make you have my babies. Gonna lay eggs inside you. Well, you could finish it with the spider. That'd be cooler. So what? That's a 52 attack. 52 and 2,000.
Damn. Attack 52. Awesome. What do you mean he doesn't pay 2,000? He paid
2,000. What does it say during the damage or
injection? Oh, is that during the damage stat? Scars attack. Yeah, during the damage calculation.
Oh, well, it doesn't matter. He still
lost. Yeah, no, well, it doesn't matter.
Because you would have just attacked with the...
Yeah, so I would have attacked. I'd been 32. Yeah. Then our difference would have been 32, so I would have gained the 32 and then attack. So it wouldn't have been game, but still.
It would have been... this guy wasn't going to win.
No. He got fucking wrecked. He got fucking wrecked. All right. Wow. That was... Mm. All right. Let me fix this. You go down to 1. Up to 3.
Yeah. Pretty solid deck. I honestly thought you built trainer, but none.
Really only need 1 of you.
Yeah.
Only you, 3 of you, 3 of you.
Soul charge?
Damn, he got wrecked. Do I need more of you? Not really. As long as I have my field spell, I always have shit to pitch.
Mm-hmm.
That's the question. Do I really need more of you? Because if I summon you from the deck, then I can't do damage.
Sounds good. 2 sounds good to me.
Damn, he got wrecked.
Limiter removal?
I could put limiter removal. I'm just going to put Oasis back. Revive these trains and go into more XE planes. Oh my god. God, this deck is evil.
Choo choo, motherfucker.
Alright, so I guess we'll wrap it up for this stream. We'll be back next Saturday. We'll probably play more of this and just get more dirty with this. Because there you go. This is the new AGVXE trains with Yubel with just dirtiness. Tekken
spiders, man. Spiders.
Spiders! Spiders! Just Patrick it up. Anyway, I hope that you guys enjoyed this live stream.
Imagine getting 2 of them out.
I know. I want to get 2 of them out so bad, but Doro is just such a strong opening play. So I hope that you guys enjoyed. Thank you, Luna, for joining me.
No problem.
And I will be back next Saturday with more Vitamin Y live stream. All right, people. Thanks for watching.